By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding of the top four no-code platforms to build an e-commerce website. This is for anyone who wants to sell something online, no matter how big or small. And what we're going to do in this video is this. We'll dive into each platform and cover who the platform is for, the pros and cons of each platform, and also the pricing. It's important to note that there's no perfect platform, and what works for you might not work for somebody else. So go through this video, learn about the four options, and then decide which one is best for you. And option one, Squarespace. Now, you might have heard of Squarespace, you might have come across this. A lot of people think that it's used for very simple websites, very simple business websites, but it's added a lot of features over the years so that you can now integrate e-commerce capabilities into your website. And we go sell products. It's going to give you a good overview about what kind of things you can do and what features they have. So it starts off with this example here you can see of someone selling jewelry. And as we scroll down, it's going to tell us that we can do things like product listings, categories, unlimited products, catalogs. You can track your inventory on this as well. And we can do things like shipping and fulfillment, simple payment and checkout options. And basically what it's going to do is just cover more or less everything that you need for an e-commerce website. So the pros of this is that there are beautiful responsive design templates. You have all these integrated e-commerce features. You have built-in marketing tools for Squarespace too. So it's a simple all-in-one platform that involves hosting and security. Now, there are a few cons with this that we can think of. Firstly, it's less scalable for large stores compared to another option that we're going to look at later. And there are limited payment gateway options. Now, when it comes to pricing, it's important to note that you should check this because it changes quite often. There's sometimes deals as well. But for selling e-commerce, we need the commerce plan or the commerce advance. So there's a basic and the advanced. So this runs at $28 per month or $52 per month if you're doing the annual plan as well, because you can pay monthly, which is $40 and $72. And this just includes more or less anything that you need to get the e-commerce store started. Now, before we go into more customizable platforms and more advanced platforms, I do want to introduce Etsy. Now, you might have used Etsy. You've probably heard of Etsy. But this is an online platform where small-scale sellers or artisans, people who do craft kind of projects, they can have their own store and sell their products on Etsy. Now, choosing Etsy means that you're using a marketplace with millions of active buyers. So you're already going into a platform that has buyers on that platform, but at the same time, you're going to be competing against other people on that platform too. So the pros are you have an instant access to a large and dedicated audience of buyers. It's a simple setup process with minimal technical requirements. You have built-in marketing tools and analytics, and you have community support and educational resources. Also, you don't need to worry too much about setting everything up in a technical sense because you're a person on that platform. Now, the cons are there's high competition within the marketplace, as we explained before. The listing fees can be quite high, also with transaction fees once that's built in too. And then there's also limited customization and branding. Now, the other thing to note that it's not on your own website, so you don't control this platform. It is on somebody else's website, which means that you have to adhere to their terms and conditions. They can change their terms and conditions at any time. Now, Shopify is a platform that is dedicated to e-commerce, and it has some really interesting stats here. As you can see, is that it takes 10% of total US e-commerce, which is incredible. Like it says here, discover why millions of entrepreneurs chose Shopify to build their business from hello world to IPO. So like from a very small startup, your first blog post, to IPOs as well. So big businesses are on this platform. Shopify is an all-in-one platform that is going to allow you to grow with the platform. So as you expand, as you delve into different markets and have different payment processes, then you'll be able to use Shopify to build with them. So the pros for this are it's a user-friendly interface and it's got drag-and-drop functionality, so it's easy to set up your online store. There's an extensive app marketplace, so you can add additional features and you can do additional things. There's built-in payment processing. and there's multiple sales channels. So for example, you can have social media integration where people can buy things on social media and Shopify sets this up for you. And because it's such a massive corporation, it's such a big platform, they have really good customer support and a very large community of users. Now, as for the cons, the monthly subscription cost can add up, especially if you use the advanced plan. And we'll talk about pricing in a moment. And there's also limited design flexibility compared to our fourth option, which again, we'll talk about in a moment. Now, as for pricing, it can get quite confusing and you might just need a little bit of time to go over this to decide which one's for you. But know that you can always upgrade and downgrade. So there's a pay monthly plan here, or you can pay yearly and save 25%. So looking at the pay monthly, the basic plan starts at $39 per month, but more complex businesses can be $2,300 a month on a 3-year term. This is obviously for a very large companies who are selling all around the world. But like I say, go through here and especially click full list of features to know more about the kind of things that it's going to offer on the different plans. Now, the final option, Webflow, is the most customizable option. And this is where you're going to build it yourself. So instead of using a platform like Shopify, like Squarespace, you're going to build this platform yourself. And you're going to have to integrate payment options and other templates and add-ons to ensure that your online store is set up correctly. But this one is going to be the most customizable, like we said, and it's also going to be the one where you completely own it. Now, you might need to have some different integrations. And what I've done here is gone on the e-commerce tab to look at the different integrations that you can use when it comes to e-commerce. So these are the kind of things that you can add. For example, Gumroad, you can use this ECDWID as well, which has multiple online stores. But you'll have to look into this a little bit more deeply and obviously know more about how to set up the Webflow store for an e-commerce website. Now, the pros for Webflow is that it has unmatched design flexibility, which means you have complete control over your e-commerce store, how it looks, the branding, the everything involved with having an e-commerce store. It has a powerful CMS capability so that you can manage this dynamic content. There are these integrated e-commerce features that we talked about, and you can also export code. So this gives you full control of your site's design and functionality and where you want to host it and how you want to move forward with it. Now, you've probably thought of some cons already, but there's a steeper learning curve here, especially for those without a design or development background. And it's a much more complex setup process compared to other no-code platforms. Webflow have the option for a plan for e-commerce so that you can unlock the features designed especially for online retailers, which is going to make it easier for you to set up. Now, this is starting at $29 a month. Again, it's billed yearly. If we go to monthly, it's $42 a month. But you can see down here, it's got 500 e-commerce items and 2,000 CMS items. And then as you go to Plus and Advanced, you get more features here. And again, I highly recommend going through all of the different features where you can look at what's involved for the different plans, especially for that e-commerce situation. So the e-commerce platform that you want to use is going to depend upon what you're looking to get out of it, how much time you want to use customizing the website, if you want access to a marketplace straight away. So let us know in the comment section which platform you prefer and if there's another platform that you're using at the moment. Want to learn more? Head over to nocode.mba to access our premium courses from top no-code experts. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you are new here. Thank you so much for watching and watch another one of our videos.